So we're ready to roll for more boxing action, and it's light heavyweights Chad Dawson and Faustino Gonzalez, presented by Miller High Life. And there is Chad Dawson. He is just 19 years of age from New Haven, Connecticut, as a pro 7-0 with 5 knockouts against limited opposition. He'll be taking on Faustino Gonzalez. He is from Bogota, Colombia, now fighting out of Miami, Florida, former police officer in Colombia. 9-5 with 4 knockouts. He has been knocked out 4 times. He's coming off a 10-month layoff. His last fight, an October 3rd knockout loss in New York at the hands of David Telesco. Steve Smoger remains in the ring.
Protect yourself. Did you explain that to your fighter? Touch gloves.
Gonzalez had 50 bouts as an amateur. He was knocked out against Andre Perlet back in 1994. I mean, he's 37 years of age. He's had long layoffs. Took all of 1997 off, most of 98. Had one fight in 2000, two fights in 2001. So he has been knocked out through 3 presidential terms.
Two southpaws facing each other in here right now. Two lefties. It's a whole new ball game for them because they're not used to fighting left. They're always used to fighting guys right-handed. I think it's very difficult for a lefty to fight another lefty.
Dawson in the black trunks, 19 years of age, in 2000 in the under-19 nationals in the amateur ranks. He came up with a victory at 165 pounds. In the amateurs, though, you do see a lot more southpaw.
A lot more, and I don't know why that is, but there's a lot of left-handers. It's sad to see a young 19-year-old guy like this. He turns pro. He'd have been great in the Olympics in the next year.
And he decided to wait. You know, sometimes, you know, they say timing is everything. He just turned 19 on July the 13th. The Olympics are in 2004. So 2 years from now, he would have been 21 as the Olympics would be getting underway in Athens.
They say it's always about the money. You want to get the money. It's too bad. Amateur could be great for you. But you might be a young man that doesn't need that much amateur experience and go on to be a champion without that amateur stuff. Faustino, a very awkward fighter, isn't he? For a guy that tall, he got down pretty low. Chad Dawson doing a lot of movement here.
What about the footwork here when you have two southpaws going against each other?
Well, and it's a right-handed guy. He gets outside that lead right foot now. There's no getting outside of it. They're both at mercy then.
Well, the 19-year-old Dawson in the black trunks and the 37-year-old Gonzalez in the red.
Definitely the old and the new, that's for sure. But the 19-year-old surely doesn't seem intimidated. Both fighters very tentative. They need to start letting it go to find each other. He never finds a range unless you throw some punches.
Dawson making Gonzalez miss. Not a lot of connects in round number one as Dawson tries to win a right hand. Coming up in the main event, we have Michael Grant taking center stage against Robert Davis. We head back to the locker room and my partner wearing a different hat tonight, or different silks, Teddy Atlas joins us. And Teddy, hey. Talked to your son earlier, he said you're pretty nervous. What's the attitude like there in that locker room?
I'd rather be with you. Don't have to worry about who wins, you know? Just have to call it for the people. Hey, there's one thing that I always tell my fighters. You wouldn't be normal if you didn't get nervous before the fight. There'd be something wrong with you. You would have been left off the line by God. If you're not nervous, you're one of two things. You're either a liar or there's something wrong with you. You need to go to a doctor. But when you get ready to make that trip, whether it's a trip in a car like it was to go to Foxwoods or a plane to go to Las Vegas, when you get that close to a fight, the one thing that saves you is you know you did everything you could do to be ready. Well, that's where we're at. That's the confidence. He's done everything to be ready. He's lived right. He's trained right. He's ready to go.
Kenny, you sound pretty confident tonight. Are you telling me that there's going to be a knockout tonight?
Look, if it comes, Scott, you know how it is in that heavyweight division. You always got to be alert, especially early on. I think early on you got to be watching. But if it comes, I'll tell you one thing about my guy. He's a very good finisher. So if it comes, we'll take it. We're not looking for the knockout. We're looking to be solid technically and mentally.
All right, Teddy, I know you're a master of preparation, and I'm sure you have some final little things you want to impart on Michael Grant. So good luck tonight, Teddy.
Thank you. Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Scott.
All right, Teddy Atlas. Warming up in that locker room with Michael Grant. Step up in class for Grant. He's got three consecutive knockout wins after his loss to Jamil McClain. Davis will pose a tougher challenge. This is Faustino Gonzalez and Chad Dawson. As nondescript, the first round as you'll find.
I'll tell you what, the second round of Faustino has come out throwing some punches and trying to be aggressive. Chad Dawson is going to have to pick it up at this point.
And Gonzalez was busier in round one. Dawson very economical, although Gonzalez did not land any kind of percentage punches. Really not a lot happening.
Gonzalez is being very aggressive at this point. He's trying to make a fight of it, and that's the key.
Well, you only fight once a year.
Should have a lot of energy, don't you think? He stored it up all year long. Now he switched over to Orthodox. That's unusual. You don't rarely see a lefty go to Orthodox. He's back over there again.
Well, he's got a 19-year-old kid in front of him.
He's surely making that kid think, I'm sure.
Lunging wide right hooks from Dawson.
The old man trying to teach young kids some new tricks.
There's a straight left hand from Dawson, and he throws a right hook to the body.
Very nice comeback there. Gonzalez doesn't hold his hands very high. Made it real easy for Dawson to step in and catch him with that shot.
Well, Dawson steps back in.
He does step back in, but Gonzalez is like an octopus. He grabs him in a hurry. Gonzalez trying to find him with that right jab. I'll say this about Dawson, he's very elusive. Very elusive.
Better round for both guys.
Hot dogs, hot dog, over here. That'll be four and a quarter.
I'll give you one and a quarter.
Hey, pal, no discounts. Hot dogs.
We want a better deal.
Everybody wants a hot dogs.
We can get you great deals on hotels.
New York for $69 a night.
How about Las Vegas?
San Francisco?
Worldwide.
All right, guys, you got a deal. Tell me more about this.
Hotels.com.
The best prices at the best places, guaranteed.
Two-time defending champion Venus Williams looks to make it three in a row at the Acura Classic. She takes on a tough field, including Monica Seles, Jennifer Capriati, Lindsay Davenport. Catch the final of the 2002 Acura Classic tomorrow live at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific, exclusively on ABC Sports.
Those Williams sisters are pretty awesome.
Unbelievable.
Billy Riggs would not want a part of that.
And the late Bobby Riggs.
Bobby Riggs, yeah.
Played Billie Jean King in the Houston Astrodome in that exhibition in the 70s.
Very good.
Take a look at the numbers from round two. Dawson picked up the pace compared to the first round. Gonzalez didn't learn much.
But threw a lot more. Double and output punches. He didn't get the landing. At least he tried to make a fight. Takes two willing participants to make a good fight. He was very defensive-minded young fighter. I said young, didn't I? 37 years old. Young compared to me, he is young.
Well, Gonzalez, Dawson, you were accurate. He is young.
19. Gonzalez has experience, and Dawson has the youth. And the quickness.
Just tuned in, Tuncho Chunchev and Luis Vialta made it through six rounds. Vialta got pummeled in round six. He got 2 points deducted. Oh, good right hook there by Dawson. And Gonzalez, the 37-year-old veteran, holds on. Tuncho was winning that fight. And because of an accidental clash of heads and cuts from round two, they went to the scorecards. Technical decision for Tuncho. Now the right hook has been the best punch in this fight for Dawson.
Been the best fight, and he's done well with it, but he's really doing good going down low to the body right now. Slapping with that left hand, very like a slap.
Look at that.
Very defensive minded. Dawson even looks like he might come forward. Gonzalez is looking for the gate.
Well, he has been knocked out four times in 14 pro bouts in a career that began in August of 1992.
Dawson's got to learn to press this guy to the ropes and then fire. When you get a guy in the ropes, he can't go back any further. Then you can close the gap.
You see Dawson now getting into a better rhythm as this fight wears on.
At our cooking school in Italy, Olive Garden chefs learn to make dishes like lobster spaghetti. Lobster and fresh spinach sautéed in creamy lobster broth, then tossed with pasta. A delicious dish they'll make for you at Olive Garden. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Using the wrong waterproofer can cost you thousands. Don't be taken for a ride. Demand Thompson's Water Seal. It has the highest level of water protection. Guaranteed. Powerful original. New advanced Thompson's Water Seal.
No one likes to refill the pitcher. Pure faucet mount filters. Clean water on tap. Pure water filters. Your water should be pure.
At our cooking school in Italy, Olive Garden chefs learn to make dishes like lobster spaghetti. Lobster and fresh spinach sautéed in creamy lobster broth, then tossed with pasta. A delicious dish they'll make for you at Olive Garden. Olive Garden, when you're here, you're family.
Welcome back to Foxwoods. Bob Papa, Scott Ledoux ringside. Teddy Atlas will be in the corner of Michael Grant, the heavyweight in our main event. This is Chad Dawson and Faustino Gonzalez. And so far through three rounds, you see that Gonzalez is averaging five connects per round. Not very good. Dawson's corner, led by trainer Gaspar Ortega, said, go to the body.
Well, that's the only thing that's available right now. If you watch Gonzalez, he leans way back and leaves his belly out there. That's the only place you can land right now. You gotta go downstairs. Maybe that guy will start bending over, you can hit him. Gonzalez is very defensive minded. It's a good fight for a young guy like Dawson to fight a guy like this, because you learn a lot fighting a guy that's just miserable.
Right.
You're not always going to fight the guys that stand up for you and let you hit them. You got to learn to fight guys like this so you can hit them. Next time you face a guy like this, he'll have a better handle on it and know what he needs to do. You can't do the big steps in. You got little shots. Very landed the left hand. He landed it with that guy. Gonzalez dropped his right arm and fired that left hand right over the top of it. He's got to come forward in little half steps. Not lunging steps. lunging step gets you off balance and you can't fire.
What do the little half steps get your feet set to punch?
Correct, and it keeps your weight on balance. When you start lunging, all of a sudden your weight's out over your lead foot. But when you take a little half steps in and close that gap, and they don't even know you're doing it to them. Little half step, just like he's doing right now. See, he's doing it, just coming a little forward, but then he can't lunge. He's got to half step him back to the ropes where the guy can't jump out of the way.
Isn't that when you hear trainers say jab your way in? By jabbing your way in, doesn't that help you get those little steps?
Right, but the young fighter like he is here, Dawson, he's coming in with a jab that's so hard it pushes the guy back. Come in with a lighter jab and follow it in there with your feet and then throw a stiff left hand like you just threw the belly. But do a little jab, rat-tat-tat, to come in behind it and let yourself get in there close enough to land that left hand. But when you're firing the jab so hard, you push the guy out of range.
Wow.
You get hurt?
I thought he stepped on the foot of Gonzalez. And then it knocked him off balance a little bit, but Dawson's sort of acting as if he got hurt.
Yes, he is.
I'll have to take a look at that during the commercial and see if he was hurt.
Clear Dry. No Clear Stick is stronger at preventing wetness. It controls sweat better, even when you're all fired up.
Confident, dry and secure. Raise your hand if you're sure.
Raise it up to 100% sure protection.
If you're sure.
Mira with the
Mira
steal.
Straight
right
through.
Oh.
Going for the ace in the hole. Hoffman knocked.
Nyquist with the goal.
Oh!
Oh, it's Nyquist off the bike. Nyquist
is
gonna send it back.
Oh, wow, actual teamwork.
Oh, he does! Mira with the score!
Finally.
The cops are coming! Come on, huh? The cops are coming to get all of you! Halftime!
X Games 8 begins August 17th on ABC.
I'll tell you, Tanjav, I thought got hurt there, and Gonzalez, I thought got him, but he steps on his foot is what happened there. That's why he got off balance. He didn't get hit at all. He just stepped on his foot and Gonzalez pulled that foot out from underneath him.
So we embark upon the fifth round of this six-round bout. No knockdown so far in the fight. Dawson averaging, you know, medium output. Actually, kind of a poor output. The most punches he's thrown in any given round are 41. Gonzalez in the red has been busier, but he's only landing five punches a round.
It's definitely funny in the defensive battle. This is a survival battle is what he's trying to fight here.
The thing of note is that the man in the black trunks to your right there, Chad Dawson, just turned 19. So he is a work in progress at 7-0 with five knockouts. The 37-year-old Gonzalez, who fights sporadically, is an awkward guy. And as Scott LeDoux pointed out in the last round, this is a good learning experience for Dawson.
Dawson's going to learn some things from fighting a guy, especially this tall in his weight division. He's got to not lunge in. He's got to come in behind that jab and real light jab and then throw the stiff one. Some young guys just don't understand it. There's three or four ways to send that jab in there, and one of them is real lightly so you don't drive the guy out of the range of your left hand. You hit him with a stiff jab, you knock him completely away, you can't aim with the left hand. Like Gregory lunged in with that right hand real hard. Just come in lightly with it and then pull and fire the left.
Who had the best jab of guys that you fought?
George Foreman. I'll tell you what, he hit so hard with that left jab. He hurt a lot. He knocked guys down with that left jab.
Did you fight Larry Holmes?
I fought Larry Holmes in 1980, yeah. He had a nice jab, but his jab was nothing like George Foreman. Larry Holmes with a rat-a-tat-tat, threw it off and scored with it, but Foreman hurt you with it.
Dawson landed a good power shot there. And Gonzalez does what he does, which is tie you up. Well, he's a former police officer, so he's good at locking you down.
That's right, controlling the suspect. I almost wonder if Gonzalez isn't a converted right-handed fighter because he slaps with that left hand. It's nothing effective about that left hand. You'd think he'd be better off as a right-hander.
The 19-year-old Chad Dawson from New Haven, Connecticut, gaining a lot of experience against an awkward 37-year-old Faustino Gonzalez.
As any military man worth his salt will tell you, the choice of artillery will vary from operation to operation. Consider a daylight maneuver with a strong civilian presence. Here you'll find the manual calls for a lighter ordnance. Mission accomplished. Sometimes the light way is the right way to live the high life.
This is your appetite talking. How about something tasty?
Introducing Arby's Market Fresh Ultimate BLT.
Ooh, the bread is so soft. All that bacon, so peppery. And those toppings, so fresh.
Arby's new Market Fresh Ultimate BLT.
BLTs me.
Made fresh to order. It'll change the way you think about fast food.
Give in to your grown-up tastes.
Michael Grant, the heavyweight, is in our main event for ESPN's Saturday Night Boxing Special presented by Miller High Life. He takes on Robert Davis. Bob Pappas, Scott Ledoux ringside. Teddy Atlas will be working the corner of Michael Grant. Earlier tonight, technical decision through six rounds for Tancho Tanchev, the two-time Olympian from Bulgaria, against Luis Pialta in what turned out to be a dirty fight, a fight that Tanchev dominated. And it was stopped on cuts caused by an accidental clash of heads, featuring a 10-6 round in that last round for Tanchev. This is Chad Dawson and Faustino Gonzalez in the ring. There have been no knockdowns so far in this fight. This is the final round. You and I have the 19-year-old Dawson in front.
The quickness is showing up now. He's snapping that right lead right in. But he's gonna have to learn how to fire inside and get his combinations out, because he can't just lunge in every time.
So if you're handling a kid like Dawson, you make sure now his next opponent is a little bit more conventional?
I don't know if you make sure of it, but you try and get somebody more conventional, because it's very frustrating when you fight a guy like this. You feel so discouraged because you don't feel like you accomplished anything, even though you're gonna get a win. I know a win is a win is a win, but you still have to accomplish something, you have to gain something, you feel good about it.
Well, you see youthful exuberance and enthusiasm and impatience there from Dawson.
Well, absolutely, there's no question, he's just not paying. If he could just slide in now with a little light jabs on the way in, move the guy right back to the ropes, then fire the left hand. Instead, he lunges in and smothers himself and can't get his punches off.
And Gonzalez with those long arms, the long arm of the law, tying up Dawson.
There's no question this guy has got the long arms, and he's just like an octopus when you get in close. He seems like he's got four arms pulling in. But his left hand is just pathetic. I don't understand that from the southpaw. Just pathetic left hand. I don't know why he doesn't go and switch to orthodox. He's much more effective with his right hand. When I say pathetic, picture yourself being a right-handed guy and trying to bat left-handed for the first time. There's not much there, and that's what it looks like.
Gonzalez, he turned pro in 92. He's only managed 14 fights as a pro. Limited results. It was awkward. A learning experience for the 19-year-old Chad Dawson. The fans dispirited. Probably the 19-year-old Dawson a little disappointed. Young guys want to have huge victories. And for Gonzalez, well, he was there. Judges' cards after this.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good old consumer research.
Man, I love focus groups.
Now, which of these two phone directories is your favorite? Yellow Book or the other book?
Yellow Book.
Yellow Book.
Yellow Book.
They're picking the wrong book.
And you?
Yellow Book. That's where I found my favorite pizza.
Charming.
Who else knows about this?
Just us.
What if Yellow Book starts to advertise?
We're in trouble.
More people choose Yellow Book, not the other book. Call 1-800-YB-YELLOW.
I will not be afraid of the dark.
I will not feel guilty leaving my dog alone.
Special. Coming up in the main event, Michael Grant and Robert Davis. We have finished this six-round bout between Chad Dawson and Faustino Gonzalez. And you take a look at the connect percentage. 7% for Faustino Gonzalez. 32% power connection for the 19-year-old Chad Dawson. Scott Ledoux scorecard. Scott had it 58-57 for Dawson. I had it 60-55 for Dawson. How do the judges have it scored? Here's our ring announcer, Jeff Connor.
Ladies and gentlemen, the judges' scorecards are in on Sugar Ray Leonard's boxing weekend at Foxwoods. Judge Arthur Mercanti Sr. scores it 59-54. Judge Steve Weisfeld sees it 58-56. Judge Robert Paolino scores it 59-55 for the winner by unanimous decision from New Haven, Connecticut. Chad Dawson.
So Chad Dawson from New Haven, Connecticut gets the win. Unanimous decision victory, 7-0. Five knockouts coming in. He's now 8-0, and he had to deal with a very awkward style in the 37-year-old Faustino Gonzalez. There he is with New England promoter Jimmy Birchfield. Still to come.